We're now going to listen to Adam. Adam, please come and join me. This is Adam. Say hi to Adam, everyone.
Hi.
Good evening.
Adam, I can ask you your age because you're a man. With Belinda, I couldn't get away with it. How old are you, Adam?
I am 45, almost 46.
Ooh, doesn't look it, does he? Come on, that's better, excellent. Andy, who needs enemies with friends? Anyway, moving on. So, now you know the Lord Jesus is your Lord and Saviour.
Oh. I do indeed.
How long?
23 years.
Excellent. But, did you know him from childhood? Was you aware of him from childhood?
Well, I think I was aware that there was a God from childhood, but I didn't actually know him, no.
Okay. Tell us about your childhood. How did you hear about God?
Well, believe it or not, I didn't actually grew up in the Caribbean, but I was born in England, but I went to the Caribbean when I was 6 months, and I grew up my younger years in the Caribbean until I was about 6 and a half, and then I came back to England. My parents were in the UK during the 60s, as most Caribbean parents were, looking for work, and then they just happened to have me when they were here. And most Caribbeans are very good, either Catholics or Church of England. And my parents were good Catholics, so I grew up as a Catholic most of my life. In fact, when I came back to this country when I was 6 and a half, I went to the local visitation church down the road, and I trained to be an altar boy till I was 12 years old. And I did all the bells and whistles and everything else.
Okay, excellent. So what happened then? What really sort of happened? How did you come to know Jesus as your Lord and Saviour?
As a young lad, about 12, in the Catholic, learning all the trade of doing altar boy, I really did it because there was a guy, was a young priest there, and he was so good worker with all the youngsters who were in the church, so I just went along and it was great. But then he got promoted, as they do in Roman Catholicism, and he got promoted and moved on to another church, and then the band of us just sort of fell apart. So then I sort of went my own way, really. My parents wasn't asking me to go to church anymore, so I didn't have to drag my heels to the Catholic Mass. So then I just did my own thing for a number of years. I went my own way, did whatever I thought was best. In the back of my mind, obviously, I knew there was a God, but I didn't think I had to do anything about it. Along the way, it's a long story, I'll cut it short. When I was about 18, I got electrocuted, plugged into the mains in my garage, as you do. And I was millimeters away, or seconds away from dying. And my brother, thankfully, turned the mains off, and I was okay. And that got me thinking, as it would. Loads of people got me really thinking about God, and but about God in a deeper sort of way, not just superficially. And then when I was 23. I knew by then that I was a Christian. I had gone through the process of actually, I remember one night in my bed, crying my eyes out and asking God into my life. But one of the things I really disliked was I didn't like the idea of going to church. And I thought Christians were hypocrites, so I thought I'm not going to go anywhere near a church. And so I sort of tried to keep my faith private for a number of years, for about 2 years. And then one day Steve came along one summer and said, oh, do you want to go and see Billy Graham? And that was in 1986. I think he was on satellite somewhere, and I thought, okay, why not one summer? I hadn't seen Steve for a few years. We've grown up together, but I hadn't seen him by then for a while. So I thought, yeah, fair enough. So I went along. And then Billy Graham, American preacher, spoke about becoming a Christian and about God and about people who didn't want to confess that Jesus was their Lord and that they were ashamed of God. And that you shouldn't really be like that. And as he was speaking, I felt he was really speaking to me, but it was the Holy Spirit convicting me that I needed to make a public declaration. So that night, at Billy Graham Mission, I went forward and made a public declaration that I was now a Christian.
Excellent. Now, if you admitted, that was obviously a number of years ago. How's life sort of leapt in front? I know some of your life. I know that he worked with my dad. Worked for British Telecom with my dad. I knew Adam when I was a teenager. But, you know, you've done that, and life's been okay, isn't it? And you're married, you have four lovely children. Yeah, and life has gone on. You've got a beautiful wife as well, and life's been okay, hasn't it? But you had a decently well-paid job, and you was okay. But what happened then?
Well, after going to university, I went and worked for BT, and I was a manager within BT for about 6 years. And then I thought, I know what I'll do. I felt it's time to go out on my own. So I decided to start my own IT company, just basically as an IT contractor. So I did that for 12 years. And in that time, I saw God's hand on me personally and on my family. God providing work in 12 years. I was only out of work for 4 weeks in total of 12 years. I didn't have work for 4 weeks. It was just absolutely amazing just seeing how God worked. And in that time, I saw God providing for me and then really asking me to go and help other people. So I first went off to Bosnia with a charity, working with children from the Bosnian War, doing summer camps with them. And that just gradually got to a point where I felt the Lord was asking me to stop work and actually go and study. So actually at the moment, I am studying theology at London School of Theology. I'm in my third year. And again, God has provided. Haven't worked for 3 years, or 2.5 years almost. And God has provided everything that we've needed. So it's just amazing that as you step out in faith and you're faithful to God, He provides everything that you need. He also changes you as well. It's amazing how He changes. And I think over the years, He's changed me more than anything else.